Hi, Backyard Birder here. I'm in the market for a new Superzoom camera for my YouTube channel, and if you're watching, I assume you're looking for a Superzoom camera too. So the way I do reviews is a little different. I'm going to talk to you like a friend or a neighbor. I'm not going to overwhelm you with a bunch of technical specifications because I've been using a Superzoom camera for many years, and you can look at videos on my YouTube channel and I'll show you some examples of what they can do. Number one thing is, you want a super zoom camera. If the high powered zoom is not your number one priority, you don't want to buy these cameras. You know, if you're going to be taking a lot of landscape photography or people photography, or you're going on a trip and the zoom is not your number one priority, there's a lot of other cameras that with better lenses for landscape and people pictures than these. So, you know, this is a super zoom camera. That's why they call it a super zoom camera. If that's not your number one priority, you should probably not be looking at super zoom cameras. Another fundamental thing that needs to be understood is photographic quality with these cameras. If anybody tells you that these cameras can produce professional quality photos of wildlife and nature, they're lying to you. These cameras are, in the price range of $400 to $500 to $1,000, a top level outfit for wildlife photography is going to cost $5,000 or $10,000. So, you know, if you're obsessed with taking award-winning photos of wildlife in action, this is probably not the camera for you. And it also depends on how much money you want to spend. So let me make that clear. You know, if you want National Geographic quality wildlife pictures or nature pictures with these super zoom cameras, that's done by carrying around high-end digital SLRs with large zoom or fixed lenses with teleconverters that weigh on the order of 5 to 10 pounds just for the camera and another 5 or 10 pounds with the tripod. This kind of photography takes money and commitment. So if you're going to be like zooming in and counting the pixels and saying, oh my gosh, this is not a perfect image, this is not the camera for you. You need to spend a lot of money and lug a lot of equipment around. What these cameras do provide is an amazing, acceptable photographs and video, especially video, for a good price that's light and tactical. Now, I've never sold a photograph taken with my SX60, but I've sold quality video to production companies working for the Discovery Channel, National Geographic, and the Animal Planet and others. So it takes really outstanding video. They also used the SX40 for several years, and it made literally 10,000 videos with the SX60 and countless thousands of photographs. I mostly take video with the SX60 than photographs. And again, I've had it for over 4 years, mostly nature and wildlife applications. If you look through my YouTube channel, there's probably 1,000 videos on there taken with the SX60. Now, I personally use mostly video. And these four cameras provide amazing video in a small, relatively lightweight package. You know, one thing that a lot of people don't realize is video with DSLRs and big lenses is extremely difficult and virtually prohibits tactical wildlife filming opportunities. In most cases, you can't use the viewfinder at all like you can with these cameras. Unless it's in a blind or a sit setup, you'll miss many tactical photo opportunities on the move. A lot of chances what you'll miss, and you just won't be able to go places that you can go with these small cameras. Most of the best video I've got has been a luck encounter with a bird or an animal, and I fire this thing up and start shooting in a matter of seconds. And sometimes you carry this for miles and miles on a hike or into the swamp or the jungle or something like that. I can guarantee you, you're not going to be carrying around 10, 20, 25 pounds of equipment and getting really good shots unless you're in a blind or something like that. And again, you're going to be spending, $5,000 to $10,000. But if your budget is in the $500 to $1,000 range, this is the right neighborhood for you to be in. You know, if money is no object, you shouldn't be watching this video. So I'm guessing most of you who are still listening to this are willing to compromise and, deal with acceptable level of photos and more than acceptable levels of quality videos. So let's look first at the Canon Powershot SX60HS, which has been my camera of choice for the last 4 years or so. I've literally taken 10,000 videos with this camera and used the electronic zoom, you know, 10, 20, 30,000 times. And it turned on this camera on and off thousands and thousands of times over 4 years. I've used it every day for the last 4 years. And one thing about this camera, and one of the reasons why I'm focusing mainly on Canon and Nikon, is I intend to do the same with the new camera. And I have never, ever had a problem with this camera in all those years and all those duty cycles and all those zooming. Of course, after that much use, these cameras, the gears that control the zooming and the servos and everything are made out of plastic. So literally, I've worn out my Canon SX60. It's like a taxi. It's worn out, and it's time to replace it. And the manifestation of wearing out a camera is the fact that the zooming, the electronic zooming, just gets noisy, and occasionally, you know, it's just not as fast as it used to be. And also the autofocus servo, you know, makes a lot of noise now that can be picked up by the camera microphone. I tend to use external microphone most of the time. You'll see reviews that say that this camera doesn't have an external microphone port, but it does, and I use it all the time. But let me just show you a shot from almost 4 years ago when I did my Canon SX60 review to show you what an awesome little camera it can be. Think this is an easy video to capture? Step back and take a look. This is one of the most difficult scenarios you're likely to encounter. This video was taken with manual focus at full 1365mm optical zoom or 65 power magnification with the new Canon SX60HS point and shoot camera, available for around $500. This camera is an upgrade to my longtime workhorse, the SX40HS, and replaces the SX50HS. This video of a winter wren was taken just the other day with the same camera I've been using for 4 years, and the video is still pretty impressive. But I'm ready to replace the SX60, and I've been waiting actually several years for the SX70 to come out. And we'll talk about the SX70 in a minute. But one thing I will say about the SX60 is that, you know, I think that it's obviously the SX70 is coming out right before Christmas, either right in early December, I think, is the updated release of the SX70. And the SX60 is already been dropped significantly in price in some places. Not so much on Amazon, but if you search on Google, you'll see some low prices. But if you start seeing the SX60 at prices of $299 or the low 300s here leading into Christmas, and you have never had a Super Zoom camera before, I'll tell you right now, that is a deal. Because this is really a good camera. 65 power is a lot, and 125 power of the Nikon P1000 is crazy. But you know, if you're just getting into this as a hobbyist or to have some fun, you keep an eye on the SX60 because they're going to be selling them really cheap, I'll bet, leading into Christmas. I've already seen prices as low as you know, $330 or something like that. You know, my advice to somebody out there that's never had one of these that wants to get into this segment for as little money as possible and have a lot of fun with a really capable camera is scarf up some of these SX60s at a low price. You know, I'm even if they go really low, like say $299, or even I don't know if doubt if they go lower than that. But if they go even lower than that, I may just buy another one just for the heck of it. So keep that in mind as a strategy if, you know, low price and introduction and hobby and having fun is your number one goal. So let's talk about the SX70. A lot of people like myself have been anxiously awaiting the launch of the SX70 for several years. It just seems like it's been delayed for a long time. And I have to say the SX70 that was announced, I think it was at the end of September, early October. You know, I have to say it was a pretty major disappointment when it came out with the exact same 65 power zoom that the SX60 had. You know, really the launch of the SX70, you know, in my opinion is, you know, is just a freshening up of the SX60. It's nothing really to get excited about. It includes an upgrade to a 4K 30 frame per second video, which, you know, should be expected with any new camera nowadays. And it has the improved DigiGate processor and some enhanced image stabilization, and depending on the parameters, it has a little faster shooting speed. So certainly it's a an improvement and freshening up of the SX60. It's just, if you're already an SX60 owner, you're looking for something more substantial as far as zoom capability, you know, to at least equal or exceed the 83 power zoom of the P900. So I'm not sure what Canon was thinking. They basically didn't really change the glass on the SX70, as near as I can tell, but they did some work on the processor and things like that, which is fine. And it's going to be a solid camera. The question you got to ask yourself in my case is, can you spend $500+ on a new camera to replace your SX60 when it doesn't increase the zoom power? Now, a big positive for both the SX60 and SX70 is their small size and their lightweight, and the way they just fit so perfectly into your hand and make it so easy to do handheld video, which most of my video is on the fly. It tends to be handheld, and it's just such an easy camera to use. It just fits into your hand. It's really compact. So that's a big plus. Both the P900 is heavier and a little clunkier to hold. Obviously, with the Nikons, with the bigger zooms, you have to accept that there's going to be a bigger size and a little more weight. Now, I'm going to let you in on a little secret, which has a lot to do with your choice between the SX70 and the P900, both that are at about the same price. The new SX70 shoots 4K video at 30 frames per second. And the secret is, many times, a single frame from that video is far superior to any photograph that you can catch in photograph mode. Now, I know that sounds like a crazy and counterintuitive, but it's actually quite true. I've used this camera, Superzooms, for 6 years now, and I can tell you I've captured a lot of great stills at 920 by 1080. Now, if you're shooting at 4K at 30 frames per second, and you get yourself on a rare bird, or your first sighting of a bird, or a bird you really want to get a picture of, I can almost guarantee you that shooting at 4K video, you're likely to get a better image than you would if you're trying to burst, especially if you're talking about maximum zoom, if you're trying to get a burst photograph that's really clear. So, that's something to think about, because the P900 doesn't have 4K video. It just shoots at 1920 by 1080. The P90 is a little bit older now. Nowadays, I think everything has to have, 4K. So that's something to think about when you're comparing the SX70 to the P900, even though the P900 has significantly more zoom at 83 power versus the 65 power of the SX70. Shooting at 4K 30 frames per second in SX70 is going to get you some stunning video and some stunning frame captures. And it also has a 4K time-lapse mode and a 4K image grab mode. That sounds pretty intriguing to me, because I know that I can get some really high quality stills out of that 4K video. And that leads right into my discussion of the Nikon Coolpix P900 with its 83 power zoom that came out well ahead of the SX70. And interestingly, the SX70 came in at 65 power instead of taking on the Nikon P900. But all things considered, when they cost about the same, there's not that big of a difference between 65 power and 83 power. There's a big difference between 65 power and 125 power. That's almost double. But the difference that you will see in day-to-day use of shooting birds and wildlife between the SX70 and the P900 is not that great to justify giving up the 4K video and the updated image stabilizer. And also, if you're used to using Canon, it's kind of like the Apple Microsoft thing. I mean, it would take something more than the P900 to tempt me away from the SX70 if I was been using Canon for a long time and I was new to the Superzoom market. So, that's something to consider. It's just so easy to carry around and use the SX70, which is actually just a hair lighter than the SX60 was. It's unfortunate that Canon didn't at least go to something like 90 power or something like that. If I had to choose between the SX70 and the P900 at that price point, it's really hard to pass up on the 4K video. I think there'll be an upgrade to the P900 sometime in the future that probably will include 4K. And that leads me to another strategy. If you're, you really want to get a Super Zoom camera, and you're just new to it, and you're a hobbyist, and things will change. If you get a SX60 at a really low price, leading into this Christmas, because they're going to be selling existing inventory ahead of the launch of the SX70. If you get a really low price on the SX60, there's nothing wrong with buying that and really having a lot of fun with it and getting used to the camera and using it for a while and waiting to see what happens next with Nikon. Will they upgrade the, they may not be in any big rush to upgrade the P900 because they have the P1000, but then the P1000 is almost twice as much. If you want to spend the $500 and some for the SX70, that's fine. But one strategy for a beginner, somebody who's sitting on the fence, and do I want to commit to buying a Super Zoom camera? I mean, I don't want to blow $500, something I may, and I want to have some fun with it. If you see a price drop on the SX60, that might be one strategy. For myself, with a longtime SX60 user, I'm not happy with the fact that the SX70 didn't exceed the P900 in zoom capability. But on the other hand, the SX70 has the 4K video and other enhancements that make it more appealing than the P900 with just a slight increase in the zoom. On the other hand, when we talk about the P1000, we're in a whole different league altogether. I mean, if you want the maximum zoom, that's your thing, zoom. I don't care if I have to pay $1,000. I want the biggest zoom. And there's no question that the P1000 is your camera. I don't think they're going to drop the price of the P1000 significantly going into Christmas. You might see a decent price drop on the P900. But again, it doesn't have the 4K video. That's the other wild card. If you see a crazy price drop on the P900, then that kind of changes the dynamic versus the SX60. I anticipate to see some really low prices on the SX60, perhaps, to watch out for. But in my case, I've been a longtime Canon user, and the Canon SX70 is certainly a capable and quality camera. I just can't see myself, in my particular case, buying it. I've got to go for the P1000. I mean, that's just where I'm at. It's significantly more expensive, but it has all the features that the SX70 has, the 4K 30 frames per second video. It also has a very nice feature on it, the P1000. It has a little bit of a manual tweak focus on it. And, a lot of times with these super zooms, one of the problems you have with focusing a super zoom is you have a very small subject like a bird against a very immense background that might be, dozens of yards further away than the bird. And so that autofocus system has to nail that bird and get it in sharp focus when there's all these moving, tree branches and everything else around. And I think that the P1000 has a pretty good autofocus system that's either equal or superior to the Canon SX70. And of course it has the 4K video. So, I'll be looking for a sale on the P1000. I don't think they'll drop it a lot, but that's what I personally will be looking for. And again, just to kind of sum up and bring to a close, this is kind of a different review than you're probably thinking about, because I can tell you that all these cameras are capable, and it really boils down to differentiating between need and price and what is your situation. So to kind of just sum up where I'm coming from as far as my advice, if you're new to it or you're a hobbyist, you just want to have some fun and get in at the lowest price point, try the SX60, especially if you see some big sales, later as we lead into a Christmas. Understanding, of course, that the SX60 is essentially an obsolete camera, but it's very capable. I'm still using it today. I uploaded a video to YouTube yesterday using the SX60. There's nothing wrong with the SX60, even though it's 4-year-old technology. The P900, You know, if it drops down in price significantly, that's another option. But then when it comes to SX70, you know, if you're in, if you want to spend like you don't want to spend $1,000, $900 to $1,000 on the P1000, but you're looking more at spending around $500, then you know the SX70 to me is the hands down choice here with its upgraded Digic processing system, its and a 4K video. So there's a lot of dynamics that go in here. I mean, they're all technically capable cameras. If you absolutely want the, you know, if you absolutely want the maximum zoom, then obviously, and money is no concern, the P1000 is the hands down choice here. So hopefully you've found this, you know, entertaining. I don't go into a lot of, you know, comparison of zooms and things like that because I've been using these cameras so long. They're all capable cameras, believe me. They're all capable. It really just boils down to where you're at in your evolution, beginner, experienced user, you're crazy for zoom power, or you're, you know, practical and you want to get some great, easy shots. You know, the one negative about the P1000 clearly is its size and its weight. I mean, it's a, you know, it's a big point and shoot camera. You know, it's a significantly different thing to carry around your neck all day long than the SX70, which is even actually smaller and lighter slightly than the SX60. I mean, the SX70 is the quick, fits you like a glove kind of camera that you can easily use shoot handheld video. You know, the weight, I think the P1000 is something on the order of a pound heavier, which doesn't sound like a lot, but it can be a lot. So anyway, you know, good luck. You know, one thing I can say is if you pick any of these cameras, you're going to have a lot of fun. And you can be assured that in my case, you know, they've last, they'll last 4 or 5 years of really extreme use. I've treated mine, you know, very harshly over the last 4 years. It's never failed to operate and never failed to be there when I need it. So, you know, have some fun, do your shopping, and hopefully I've provided a little insight into the Superzoom process. Good luck.